Loso, our Minister of Music, and Pastor Bob Creesat, our Pastoral Associate here at Faith. My thanks to John Everson, who is our Assisting Minister this afternoon, and thanks as well to Alex Bonenberger and to Gary McCready, who are recording our service for us today. Just a few notes before we begin. There is an organ recital following our service today and each of our Wednesdays during Advent, and hope that you will stay around and listen to that. And in addition, we will be going over to St. John's Soup Kitchen tomorrow with sandwiches, and we would invite you to drop off those sandwiches and goodies in the kitchen before 9 o'clock on Thursday, and we will get those over to Newark. In your prayers this week, we ask that you remember all those on our prayer list, and particularly remember our friends at Broadway House, our AIDS ministry in Newark, as yesterday we marked World AIDS Day, and we have been going to Broadway House now for 15 years. So special, special ministry for all of us here in the family of faith. I would invite you now to join me for our confession. Let us call to mind our baptisms as we gather to worship in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We gather here to enter into the presence of God, to be comforted by the gift of the Holy Spirit, to remember the promise of hope which is ours through Jesus Christ. As we prepare to be touched by God's grace, we confess our sins. Most merciful God, we confess that in thought, word, and deed, we have turned away from you. We ignore our neighbors in need and fail in the labor of justice and peace. In your mercy, forgive us, renew us, and lead us. Grant us wisdom to welcome your light and to seek the things that will endure until Christ comes again in glory. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share with one another a sign of God's peace. Peace be with you. Peace. Peace be with you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Stir up your power, Lord Christ, and come. Keep us awake and alert to your coming, and strengthen us to the end, that we may be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Our reading is from Psalm 89, beginning at the first verse. The psalmist writes, "Your love, O Lord, forever will I sing. From age to age, my mouth will proclaim your faithfulness. For I am persuaded that your steadfast love is established forever. You have set your faithfulness firmly in the heavens. I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn an oath to David, my servant. I will establish your line forever and preserve your throne to all generations." Here ends the reading.
Fade away and grow.
our song. Those of you who know me know that love songs are not my strong point. I mean, I've got nothing against love, but sometimes love songs get mushy, sentimental, all kinds of stuff. So I tend not to like them that much. And so people that I love rarely, if ever, hear me sing them a love song. Now, this morning, we can't get away from it. For the theme for today is Love Be Our Song. And the words essentially come from David's psalm that for us is called Psalm 89. And there is a love song that I probably can sing. Here's a love song I would probably, well, not even probably, here's a love song that I would like to sing. I will sing of your steadfast love. Notice, it's not my steadfast love. It isn't even Pastor Jane's steadfast love or John's steadfast love. We're talking about God's steadfast, ever-abiding love, that there is nothing, our Lord tells us, that can separate us from the love of God. Nothing. Whether it's a pandemic, whether it's political, whatever it is, nothing can separate us. And so the psalmist says, I will sing of God's steadfast love forever and ever. I don't know if you have love songs. You've got some memorized. I'm sure John has many of them. But maybe it's time for us to very consciously sing a love song to God. Sing of God's love to us. The kind of love that sustains us and holds us day in and day out. Love will be our song. Amen.
Expectation. Let us pray for the church, for the world, and all people in need. For the church, that it may be a herald of glad tidings, announcing the good news that you are drawing near. Lord, in your mercy. For all who strive for peace, an end to conflict and war, that righteousness may find a home in their midst. Lord, in your mercy. For wilderness and desert terrains, for mountains and plains, for fields fallow in the winter, and for fruitful vegetation during these summer days in the southern hemisphere, Lord, in your mercy. For all who are weighed down with economic instability, sorrow, anxiety, or sickness, that you speak tenderly to them and comfort them in your compassionate embrace, Lord, in your mercy. For this community of faith, that in our busy and fast-paced lives, you will grant us the gift of patience and trust in your steadfast love. Lord, in your mercy. We give thanks for your holy ones who faithfully prepared the way of the Lord. Open our eyes to the new heavens and new earth made known in your advent among us. Lord, in your mercy.
Into your hands, gracious God, we commend all those for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray now as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Let us pray. Gracious and abundant God, we rejoice in all that you have done for us. In your boundless mercy, strengthen us and open our hearts to the needs of your world as we await the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, prepare the way of the Lord. Thanks be to God.